At the outset, Lily Ajarova's skin color and hair will make one think she's not African, but she was born and raised in Uganda. Her father is Italian, while her mother is an Alur from Nebbi district in West Nile. At her rural school, she was not accorded special treatment like it's normally assumed. When all pupils were ordered to cut off their hair, her excuses didn't help.
We had this really rude teacher, and all he did was went and got a pair of scissors and made a long line, you know, right in the middle of my head. What I understood from it later was like the teacher felt that, you know, I was being treated differently.
She went to primary school through to O-level in schools in Nebbi and completed A-level in Arua. She later joined Makerere University for a bachelor's degree in psychology and sociology. Afterwards, Lily obtained a scholarship to study tourism in Austria. When she returned, she worked with a tour company, moved on to the Uganda Wildlife Authority before joining the Chimpanzee Sanctuary. It has been a worthwhile experience for her.
Visiting all the national parks, visiting all the wildlife reserves, I know my country really well. There's no place in Uganda I haven't been to.
Lily found her passion early in life. As a six-year-old, she had her first close encounter with a wild animal, an elephant, during a class trip. But the teacher became so engrossed in taking pictures of the elephant that he forgot about his charges.
It drew the attention of the mother elephant, who started charging at us. And the one thing that I still remember up to now is the trumpet.
Lily is well-traveled. She has visited many parts of the world, but she is convinced Uganda is indeed the pearl of Africa.
We have it all in the small basket in Uganda. Kibale National Park has the highest diversity of primates. There are over 12 different species in that little national park than any other place in the world.
She is concerned, though, that this diversity is largely untapped.
We could entirely develop this country if we developed just our tourism industry.
As a conservationist, it pains her that Rwanda, Kenya and South Africa have less in diversity than Uganda, yet annually they earn billions of dollars from tourism compared to Uganda's returns.
Look at the budget that we have for tourism in Uganda. It's the smallest in the region. We need technical training, yeah, on how the service has to be delivered. Yes, we can smile, but there's a way that we need to do it professionally.
She would like to see the younger generation growing up with a sharper awareness of their environment and the need to preserve it.
When we had the Bududa incident, I saw a member of parliament saying, you see, this is all the problem because of Uganda Wildlife Authority keeping all the land. And I'm like, that is a member of parliament talking? Do they understand?
She has three children of ages ranging from 12 to 18. Her husband passed away 9 years ago, and the family has learned to support each other.
We have to have open communication at all times.
Lily has taught her children to appreciate nature as opposed to the many other attractions available today.
I keep telling my children, don't ever come to me and say I'm bored. Because you cannot be bored. Just go in the compound, count the different kinds of ants and plants, and the boredom will go away.
One of the things that pains her deeply is that many Ugandans don't appreciate their country's natural beauty. Many spend their money binge drinking on weekends and rarely travel their country.
Every evening, every single day, yeah, the muchomos and the beers being consumed between Wandegea and Ntinda. How much money is being spent?
Our best bet, she says, would be to pick a leaf from Europe.
Between high school and college, kids are encouraged to travel. One, to know their country. Two, to know the whole of Europe. And many times they're encouraged to take a dead year to work, save and travel Europe.
While many schools in Uganda undertake study tours, it is mostly the privileged children whose parents can afford to pay the fees who travel. She argues that Uganda has a lot more to offer in tourism than most people know.
When I'm at Ngamba Island, my day starts at 5:30, and I go with my cup of tea or glass of water on the viewing platform to wait for the sunrise at 6 o'clock. And for every overnight visitor who has been to Ngamba Island, I've tried to sell that. And I have this year 4 groups coming back for the sunset.
Lily is passionate about her work at the island, but it pains her that some unscrupulous people still trade in wildlife even when it's lucrative. Some people think baby chimpanzees make good pets because of their friendliness.
They laugh, they play around, you know, they do things like human babies do. By age 4, they start taking control over their own lives. Then they become really aggressive. And we have had stories of people, you know, being seriously injured and even killed by, you know, pets they keep.
She has been so close to chimps that their habits are ingrained in her brain.
I can relate you to one of the chimps from your personality.
One move that Lily appreciates government for is signing up to international treaties to protect these species, and that there are laws to protect wildlife. Josephine Karunji, NTV.